Good morning. So today we are going to see about the mode characteristics of Klystron power supply. So for this we are going to use a microwave bench which is going to operate at X band, that is the frequency in terms of gigahertz. So this is your setup. What you are seeing in the bench is a microwave bench. It consists of first Klystron power supply connected to your Klystron tube, and then this is connected to your isolator. From the isolator it is connected to your frequency meter. This is your detector mount, and the probe of your detector mount is connected to your CRO. So this is your Klystron power supply. So initially when you are going to switch on this Klystron power supply, the precaution should be taken is the beam voltage knob should be kept at a minimum, rippler voltage knob should be kept at a maximum, and all these four knobs what we are using it should be in the minimum position. So first I am switching on this power supply, you can see here. So first, this is your meter select switch to adjust your B voltage, C current and rippler voltage. And this is your modulation switches, whether we can use in your AM modulation or we can use in a FM modulation. And this is your continuous wave modulation. So these switches will be used according to the experiment we are doing. So totally here you can see the six adjustment knobs. So first one, this is your beam voltage. The beam voltage should be minus, that is 195 to 300. So first for this adjustment I am going to keep this meter select knob at voltage. So we can see here adjusting the beam it will increase. So I am keeping minimum is your 190 and maximum is your 300. So I am selecting the beam voltage to 235. And then next, this one is your rippler voltage. This for this next switch is current. The current should be 0.16. The maximum current we can use is 0.30 milliamps. Next we can see your rippler voltage. This is a rippler voltage adjustment knob. So if I change this rippler voltage, you can see the values changing in your screen. So the rippler voltage we can set up to minus 273. So these four knobs are used for your modulation for AM and FM. So here we can see the modulation switch. So I am tuning this to AM. So if I tune this to AM, I can adjust these two knobs of amplitude and frequency. Similarly, if I change this FM, I can use this amplitude and frequency change for this corresponding frequency modulation. So these are the initial adjustments we can set. So I am keeping here, now it is a rippler voltage. You can see here minus 250. If I further increase, the maximum value is minus 273. So for this corresponding rippler voltage, I am tuning this modulation in your AM. So if I set first AM, I can adjust these two knobs used for your AM, that is amplitude and frequency. For this corresponding rippler voltage, the waveform, that is a square waveform, will be generated in your AM, that you can see in your screen of your CRO. For the maximum rippler voltage, that is around minus 272, you will be getting a square waveform. The modulation is amplitude modulation. You can see the waveform over your CRO, which is your square waveform. So this is your rippler voltage output square waveform. So if I reduce your rippler voltage, if I reduce the rippler voltage, you can see your output voltage will be decreasing and it will be zero, and again it will be increasing. So you can see here again. So this is your maximum value of a rippler voltage. If I reduce the rippler voltage, you can see here the output will be reduced to zero and it will again increase to your maximum value. So this is called as a mode characteristics of your Klystron tube. Okay. So again I am reducing your rippler voltage. You can see here the power is decreasing to zero and again it is increasing. So this is one mode. And again, you can see again some power is decreasing to zero, and this is your second mode. And similarly, I am reducing your rippler voltage, the power is again decreasing and increasing to zero. So this is how we can analyze the mode characteristics of your Klystron. So after that, we are going to now measure your frequency of your microwave signals. So this is your frequency meter, you can see. The range of the frequency meter is 8 GHz to 12 GHz. So if I tune this frequency meter, you will be getting some dip in your waveform. So you can see here, I'm little bit adjusting your frequency meter. You can see here, you can see the waveform over your square waveform. It is going to dip now. So I'm adjusting the frequency meter slowly. So you can see the dip here over here. So this is the maximum output we are getting. So when I tune the frequency meter, so you'll be getting some dip like this, and again it will be increasing. So this is called as a dip of your square waveform signal. So you can see the dip over here, and this will be the minimum voltage we can measure from the CRO. This is the minimum voltage we can measure from your CRO. So we can see here the voltage's value here. So we are going to measure this voltage. When this voltage is multiplied with your, so this is the output waveform you can see. So the voltage will be measured using this wave, and this voltage multiplied with your beam current will give you your power. So this is one power you can measure using one Rippler voltage. Similarly, if I reduce the Rippler voltage, you'll be getting another mode like this. Okay. Again, I'm going to adjust the frequency meter. So I'll be getting a power of this. So this power, this sine square wave power, can be measured using your voltage knob in the CRO, and you can measure the total power using this experiment. So this is how we can calculate your frequency of your Klystron power supply, and we can analyze the mode characteristics of Klystron power supply. This is the tabulation for your mode characteristics of Klystron power supply. For different values of the Rippler voltage, we are going to measure the output power from your CRO. So if the Rippler voltage is -220, you can see the power is 24. So similarly, for various values of your voltage, we can measure the power. So, and also a graph will be plotted between your voltage and power. Voltage will be taken across your x-axis and power will be taken across your y-axis. So this is a graph showing your output power across y-axis and Rippler voltage across your x-axis. So using the tabular column, we can draw the graph like this for your various mode characteristics of your Klystron power supply.